Have you ever fallen sick in Germany and maybe you wondered what you have to do as an employee when you fall sick? Like, is there a process in place or something? If you've stayed in Germany long enough, you may be wondering about this, because then I'm sure you're already well aware that there is a process for everything. So that's why today I'm going to talk about this great yellow sheet of paper, which is called Arbeitsunfähigkeitsbescheinigung. I don't know if you've ever heard of it. If you've stayed in Germany long enough, I'm sure you have. And then you've probably received a yellow sheet of paper like this before. If not, I'm pretty sure that it's good to know about it so that you are informed and you don't need to worry about it if you ever, if you ever don't feel well. But before I'm going to explain to you what an Arbeitsunfähigkeitsbescheinigung is, make sure that you hit the subscribe button on this great YouTube channel. Never miss out on any of our great videos. If you have done so already, I'm really glad to have you as a subscriber. And I hope that these videos bring some value to you. If there are any topics you would like us to cover, leave us your comments. We are always working on trying to bring topics out to you that are relevant for you and trying to answer your questions. So whatever is bugging you related to job search and careers and life in Germany, do let us know and maybe we can create a great video for you that'll answer your questions. But let's get back to this, right? So Arbeitsunfähigkeitsbescheinigung is a Bescheinigung. Bescheinigung is a German term you will learn, I think, at a very early stage when you move to Germany. If you're already living here, I'm very, very sure that you already know this term. A Bescheinigung is a kind of confirmation, a document stating that, or confirming something. So in case you fall sick, it's a confirmation by the doctor confirming that you're not capable of going to work because you're sick. And this is very important. In Germany, we like all types of Bescheinigung, right? So when you fall sick, the first thing you should, of course, always do is to notify your employer, inform your colleagues, cancel your meetings. And maybe if you already have a kind of gut feeling of how long you'll be sick, if it's not just a day or several days, maybe just give them a rough estimate. At least that's what you're supposed to do. But the most important thing is, do inform them as early as possible before seeing a doctor even. You are obliged to inform them before your day of work starts. That's just important to know, because sometimes people decide that they want to go and see a doctor first. So if you're not sure what the doctor will say, just inform them that, hey, I'm not feeling well, I'm going to see a doctor, and then I'll inform you what the doctor has said and if I'm capable to work in the next days or not. That's also sufficient. You will know best what matter of like what way of communication is best within your company, what's best to use. I'll leave that up to you. The most important thing is that you've informed them in a kind of formal way and in a way that's fast. So of course, sending a letter is not sufficient, but maybe an email is a way to go. Maybe your company uses a Slack tool, then Slack is a good way to inform your colleagues. That's up to you. Then the next step is to figure out if you need something like this and at what stage you need it. In Germany, as per the legal framework, you will need a proof of your, let's say, inability to work. We, in German, by the way, we also call this Attest. Maybe that's an easier word to say. So you will need an Attest if you are sick for 3 days or more. Then you need to hand in something like this. And I'll tell you why in a minute. But just to let you know, there are some companies who already require you to hand this in on the first day of your absence. And handing it in means handing it in physically at your employer. So it has to be on your employer's desk, your boss's desk, whoever your supervisor is, on the first day. In the case of some companies, for most of them, it's on the third day, but I've seen different cases. So just make sure that you check this. I hope you are all safe and healthy right now, but it's just good to be aware of it. So maybe just ask about it when you do your onboarding, so that you don't have to worry about it when you actually fall sick, right? It's always good to be aware of it beforehand. So that's just important. If you have to hand it in on the first day, you need a doctor's appointment on the first day. And I think that's really important to know, because I know that sometimes In cities for like Berlin, for instance, it's a bit challenging to get a doctor's appointment, right? So you have to kind of know your way around and figure that out. If the third day is sufficient, then maybe you don't have to go and see a doctor right away. If you feel unwell, but not, you know, that unwell, that's up to you. But you may need it if you are absent for 3 days or longer, then it's definitely the case. So that's always defined in the internal policies. Just ask about it. That's the best way to go about it. And let me tell you why this is important for the employer to have. I was not aware of that when I took up my first jobs, and I always wondered about it, because when you fall sick, your doctor will often ask, so do you need an attest for your employer? It's like, yeah, okay, yes, I'm an employee, so yes, I need it. Right now, that's not the case anymore. I'm self-employed, but okay, yeah, I need it. And then you walk out of the doctor's, and then you don't just get this, but you get a second sheet of paper, which looks exactly the same. It just has a different color, and it says something different up here. Not that relevant. So the yellow one is for your employer. So that's the one you have to hand in. The other one is just for you as a proof. And this document states how long you will be incapable to work. And usually it can be extended. So it says that as well on the Bescheinigung. And then of course it states your address and so on. And this is important for your employer and for you as well, because if you fall sick in Germany, the nice thing is that you will still get your salary. So your employer will continue to pay your salary, usually for up to 6 weeks. And if you have a kind of serious illness, then your health insurance steps in and takes over after this time frame. And that's where this sheet of paper becomes really important, because your employer will hand this in at the health insurance to prove that you were continuously absent due to health issues. And there's a code on it which shows or indicates the diagnosis you had or the reason why you were not able to work. And this is what the health insurance checks for, to figure out if you are actually continuously absent because of the same health issue, sickness. Yeah, what happened? Maybe you had an accident. I hope this doesn't happen to you, but you never know, right? So in that case, the health insurance steps in and takes over the payment of your salary, or compensates it actually. And that's why this is really important to keep if you ever fall sick in Germany. If it's just for a few days, it's not that important. But if you have something serious, just make sure that you don't lose it, because it's all about getting your salary, right? So it's important for you and for your employer, just to be aware of it. Anyways, I hope you stay safe and healthy out there. As I already said, I hope you're not watching this video because you're not feeling well right now, but just to keep yourself informed. If you're not feeling well, I hope you'll feel better soon. Leave me your comments. Also, if you ever had a situation like this, maybe share your experience with us. The more we share, the more we can learn from each other. And I think that's always helpful for everyone in our community, right? So leave us your comments, subscribe to this great YouTube channel, and see you soon.